All right, welcome to another edition of Koffee and Kramer, episode number 18. I'm Joey Kramer.
And I'm Jennifer Koffee.
And we are Koffee and Kramer. She is sneezy this week.
She's still a little under the weather.
She took off the top nine at nine.
I had to have
Tony Anks do the top nine at nine last week. If you're interested in something funny, go to decadesofjoeykramer.com and you'll find out the reason why Tony Anks isn't in radio. But anyway, she's been sick since about last Tuesday now.
No, it's last Thursday.
It's about last Tuesday that you've been sick since.
No.
You came home early one day
Thursday. And
you slept the whole day.
Thursday.
Then you didn't go to school on Friday and you slept the whole day.
I did.
Saturday, I dragged it to the radio station.
Okay, so there's two different worlds in our house.
Mine and yours.
When I don't feel well.
Oh, here we go. Here we go.
I just want to crawl in bed, pull the covers over my head. I don't want to talk to anybody. I don't want to look at anybody. I just want to sleep.
Here we go.
When Kramer is sick, he wants to be waited on. He wants to be brought food in bed. He wants to be checked on every half hour. He wants his pillow fluffed. He wants drinks brought to him. He wants somebody to take care of him. I don't
Here
feel that
we
way.
Go.
So
Here we
when
go. Here we go. Ready?
He comes to check on me. Don't make me laugh, because then I will cough. So when I get mad at him for bothering me and waking me up. Okay, enough of the violin.
I'm just playing the violin music while you complain about.
Just, it's not complaining. Two different philosophies. I'm done.
I'm just saying, he gives you a little violin music. I like to be taken care of when I'm sick.
And I like to be left alone when I'm sick.
And I do everything possible to try to take care of you when you're sick. Because Koffee will not take any medicine.
I don't want you to take care of me.
She won't take any medicine. She won't call the doctor. All she wants to do is lay there, and she doesn't get any better the whole time.
I just want to sleep. Don't bother me.
And I get lose complete control of the household. With my they did that to me when they were younger.
They still do it to me.
And it still happens.
They take control. It's pretty amusing.
I usually end up just going up to bed and hiding.
I do hear it. But I pull the covers over my head and
I don't even, anything can happen when you're not there and you don't even come down to see if I'm okay.
Nope. I don't. I shouldn't have to. You're an adult. There are two adults. I shouldn't have to come down.
But what about when I was an adult and they were children and they knew how to like terrorize me?
That was fun. I used to laugh listening to that.
They used to completely terrorize me until I ran up to bed and I put the covers over my head.
You used to leave two children alone.
Like when you were working and you'd come home and you made dinner and they say, well, you know what? Dad usually brings our dinner into us and asks us if I want seconds.
Yeah, I'm not their maid.
You just plop it on a plate for them and say, here, take it.
I don't even do that. I put it in the pot and I say, come serve yourself.
Dad brings it to us.
Yeah, you did. I remember when I was working at night and you were feeding them dinner. That's what they used to say.
I would give them their dinner. I mean, they were like 12 or whatever.
Well, like, bring them to the table.
They were like, I never liked eating at the table. I have nothing to say at the table.
Ridiculous. I always hated that. I always hate that we don't eat at the table.
Well, that we did eat at the table. We used to, but then you got us out of that.
I don't think so.
You wanted to watch something on TV or something.
No.
And that's why it happened. We just never did. We would always be able to see the TV. So then we just started. You know what really happened? Sports happened.
That's what happened.
We had sports all the time.
Everybody eats at a different time.
During the summer, we had softball. During the winter, there was basketball. There was always something going on where we had practice. We couldn't eat at 5 o'clock. We'd have to eat at 7 o'clock. One person would have to eat by 4. Another person would have to eat by 7.
You're right.
So it was very hard.
But what's the excuse now?
Well, now they're not here as much, which we're not going to complain about. That's a good thing.
I understand.
But
I still
again,
like sitting down at a table together.
Sammy goes to work. She doesn't get home. She gets her lunch at 7:30?
I know.
Tony, we just are happy whenever she's not here.
Stop it.
And she's in and out all the time.
They are. But But what about, what's the excuse for us?
Why would we? Okay, if it's just the two of us like tonight.
Why can't we sit at the table and talk and eat dinner? Because then if we talked at the table, I wouldn't be talking at other times when I shouldn't be talking.
This is going to be the secondary conversation of the evening. We'll get to that in a little bit.
Wow.
Where my wife.
Maybe that's part of the
issue. Where my wife loves to have conversations. Because there's one place that she does not shut up for 2 seconds. And this has been like this for 30 years.
Don't do it on purpose.
She would not shut up for 2 seconds.
You say to me, what more do you have to say? And it
okay, I'm just...
just spills out.
I also celebrated my 50th birthday, which my wife was not part of because she was sick. Were you sick for it?
I was there.
When was it? Last Wednesday?
Yes. I told you I got sick on Thursday.
But didn't we... It was Wednesday, so when did we record the podcast?
Wednesday.
We already talked about it then.
That night, like after, yeah.
Yeah, well, you should talk about your 50th birthday.
Well, we were talking about your rules for...
Oh, I do have rules. I don't know if anybody... I get a kick out of people when we're watching these shows like on HGTV or whatever, and they're looking for a house, and their first thing is always, we can entertain here. This would be great for entertainment.
That would be Joey Kramer's checklist.
We need another room so people could stay here. I mean, I'm sorry. I have a rule in my house when you come over. It is you get, depending on the time of the day, but let's say it's an evening thing and we're going to say eat at 5 o'clock. Okay. You can get to my house at
4:30.
So you get a half hour ahead of time to talk. We then give you 1 hour to eat, 5 to 6. Then you get 6 to 7 to wrap things up. And by 7 o'clock, you're done.
That's even pushing
it. Even on my birthday, everybody came over at 7 o'clock. It was like 9 o'clock and they were still here. I'm like,
and we didn't even serve dinner.
I finally said, okay, it's getting a little late here. You know, everybody's been here for 2 hours. Thank you very much. Time to move on.
Yeah, that's his rules.
Had them all over. We had Chris next door and we had, Horny Terry
Naughty Terry.
Dirty Terry. Naughty, what's it?
Naughty.
Naughty Terry. And Crazy Chrissy and Carol across the street. And my parents were here and your father was here and the Sam was here.
And we took ice cream to Graham's.
And Graham's next door got ice cream. We took over to her.
So our neighbors do still talk to us, yes. For those of you that think that.
It was a very nice birthday. And
the neighbors in our triangle.
My Amazon gift card balance got inflated.
You did?
So, yes.
That was
all
a surprise.
And all I've ordered was an Amazon as a Adidas
sweatshirt.
Or a Reebok sweatshirt. That's all I've ordered out of all that. Because my favorite time of the year is now coming.
Because now you're going to save it for something.
So now, coming
something
up,
big.
Well, Prime Day is October 11th and 12th, so that's big. But November 1st officially kicks off Christmas in the Kramer household, which means I visit all my decorations. Like, I put them away in January. Day after Christmas, everything is down. I don't like having after New Year's. I'm sorry. I start the day after New Year's Eve.
Yeah.
New Year's Day, they're all gone. I start putting my decorations up November 1st because I have a big display. We have a big tree, street lighting on the day before Thanksgiving where all the neighbors come out, the ones that we like. Some of them we tell them not to come. And we light all the... We light
cocoa and cookies and light.
Right.
And last year we even brought one of the local TV celebrities came out.
Crazy Chrissy brings her Irish coffee out or whatever she makes.
She usually does.
Her cocoa that she spikes with bourbon or something.
She does.
But I started on November 1st. But what you don't know, I think you just found this out, that I visit my decorations all year. Because I feel bad for him putting them away in that back room in January. So usually like around March, I go down. I usually open up the back door and see how they are. Because I feel loneliness that they're only put out for 2 months.
That sounds a little crazy.
So I go in there in March and I visit them. Usually in the middle of the summer because it's so hot. In like July, I go back there for Christmas in July. And I say, yo, it's Christmas in July. You're almost ready. And I just paid them a visit 2 days ago.
Yeah.
And I said, guys, gals, you're going to be coming out in less than a month. And they all cheered.
They cheered?
Yes, because November 1st is going to be coming out. So we're only like 3.5 weeks from beginning the setup of Christmas. I did get 2 giant 12-foot trees that are going to be put in front of Dirty Terry's house.
Naughty Terry.
Naughty Terry's house on the side. As long as Chris reminds me to bring home the poles, I'm going to have those. So I always add one or two more things. I did want to get a bigger light show, but somebody won't let me buy the lighting controller that I really need.
Although, good thing you have Amazon cards.
Well, that won't cover it.
Yeah, well, then I guess you're not getting it.
The controller itself is about $500, but you get a program on your computer and I could run these lights.
No.
Awesome. It would be absolutely awesome.
No.
Money's there to spend. We make a nice life, a nice living. Is there anything left at the end of the month? Not always.
So Kramer's a spender.
We don't go without. Put it that way.
We don't.
Is there anything we have that we don't go without? We might not have put tons of money away, but
vacation because Kramer won't leave 5 minutes from the house.
That is true. What good is money sitting in a bank? I know a lot of people who put money away and it sits in a bank and are using it for this and then they die. And then where did all that saving of money, all the saving of the money's gone. So you save all this money your whole life. You have this big nest egg and then they're dead.
So when I retire, are you willing to go out and work part time?
For what?
If we need extra money because we didn't save.
You're a teacher.
So what?
You get paid afterwards. You get buyouts. And
not as much as what I get paid now.
And if you die, I get like $400,000. And if it's an accident, I get more.
Okay.
And I do have a big life insurance policy on both of us.
Okay.
I have plans, baby.
I'm glad.
If you go, I'm going to get myself a nice blonde-haired, blue-eyed girl. I'd have to really search for somebody who's going to take care of me.
Yeah.
I'd have to do interviews.
That would be difficult.
Because the thing is you do for me. I appreciate you.
Yeah. You don't realize what you've got until it's gone.
I'm not as, you know, you make me seem like I am like.
Like what?
High maintenance. And I'm not.
You are high maintenance.
I'm not really high maintenance at all.
You're actually really high maintenance.
There's not a lot of stuff that you have to do for me to make me happy. Which we'll be getting to that in a few minutes.
You keep me pretty on my toes.
All right. I get new kind of show prep, which is like radio lingo for stuff. What?
We're not loving it.
Well, if I got to pay for it, this is basic. I could pay for it $12 a month.
Yeah.
And get more, but I like it. You don't like it?
Well, we always seem to find the articles we like. They cut off halfway through because you didn't pay for it.
See, like a study found that if you want to reconnect with your significant, you should take a road trip. So if you're having a problem with your wife or your husband, whatever, the best way to reconnect is to get on the road with them. With us, that's not true because we are not
good travelers.
I don't mind going. I have a 5 mile radius thing.
We're gonna save some money to hire a driver,
except for certain places. Like the Bloomsburg Fair was great. No pressure. Had a great time at the Bloomsburg Fair. And bonus.
Okay, here we go.
This was a bonus for everything.
We did talk about this.
Did we talk about this?
I think so.
I got the Pizza Hut. So that was like a whole bonus being down at the Bloomsburg Fair. But then, because I've had 90-some jaw surgeries, which we're going to base an episode just on my surgical life.
See, all about you.
What? I'm just saying.
High maintenance. You were just saying you're not high maintenance.
Well, I've had 90 jaw surgeries since 1990.
That's not high like maintenance. Like my surgeon. Nothing is.
I go down to see my surgeon. He fist bumped me when I walk in because he knows he's getting, you know, another car or something when he has to do something. And this one sits there. No unnecessary surgeries because he's a plastic surgeon. And she was nervous because I got a chin tuck last time and I got a brow lift. Well, he had to fix stuff.
When you've had 90 surgeries, you don't get to have an elective surgery.
Yeah, but when you have to get stuff fixed.
You don't get an elective surgery.
After that last surgery, my skin was hanging and my eye was hanging. He had to fix it. He didn't like the way it looked.
Yeah, and now he has to fix something else.
Well, no, because now the plate in my face, he says, makes me very nervous because he just stares at me and he goes, I don't know about that.
Can we first state that if anybody watches Grey's Anatomy.
Oh, here we go. I have Dr. McDreamy as my doctor.
No, you don't have McDreamy.
Is that what you're
going to
say?
Who was McDreamy's best friend?
I don't know. I didn't watch. I only watched like 3 seasons.
No, he was in the first season.
I don't remember. What was the other guy's name? George?
No, he wasn't George.
You mean the one who just left recently?
No, the one that died.
Everybody dies. He's like the our doctor's like the George Clooney of...
No, he's not George Clooney. No.
Okay, here we go.
No, I got to look it up.
Well, if you're looking for any t-shirt designs, I'll say it this week. Sam is still doing a bunch. This is her new thing. She's doing a ton of t-shirts. I think she's doing breast cancer awareness t-shirts right now. She could do any kind of t-shirt you want. I'm going to look up her stuff on Instagram, SamanthaFaith.creative. Facebook, Samantha Faith Creative. Her website, SamanthaFaithPhoto.com. Coffee mugs, pumpkins. She'll do it right to your skin, kind of like a tattoo, right?
No. What?
I thought she said she could put it right on your skin.
No, she doesn't do it on your skin.
But anyway, you can get all kind
she
of t-shirts.
Custom prints.
Like any kind of custom t-shirt you want, which I'm going to get Coffee over here one that says, they're going to have a sweatshirt and a hood. It's going to say, I'm cold 24/7. Because that's what always she says. She has a sweatshirt on in the middle of July. It's 90 degrees out.
Correct.
And she wears a sweatshirt. But we'll go for a walk on a night where it's in the 40s, and she'll be telling me how she's sweating.
Well, you know, at this time of life. Yeah,
this time of life. Another part of a...
So let's go back
Another part of a man's problem. I'm going to talk about this a little bit.
No, wait. Let me go back to Grey's Anatomy.
Well, I'm thinking about this for a second.
No, wait.
Go ahead.
I'm first.
Go ahead.
He's Dr. Mark Sloan.
I don't know who that is.
Yes, you do.
I don't.
It was Derek's best friend.
I don't know who Dr. Mark Sloan is.
He was a plastic surgeon on there. And yes, you do.
Dr. Mark Sloan.
Yes. You know who Mark Sloan is.
I'm going to type it up here.
There
and
it
see.
Is on Grey's Anatomy. Yes.
Where?
You know exactly. Top on the top. You know exactly who it is.
Well, that's the guy I was thinking of.
Yes. Well, that's his name.
Yeah. Well, that's kind of like what he looks like.
Yes. He looks exactly like that. So
he got killed.
Oh, yeah.
How'd he get killed? Probably a train ran through the emergency room.
I think it was the airplane. Wasn't it the airplane
crash?
Oh,
the airplane. That's right. Airplane crash.
Yeah, jeez. I think it was. But anyway, so his doctor is very well put together, very handsome.
Is this nice that my wife is down there and she's like, wants to hit on my doctor?
I don't want to hit on him. He's just nice to look at.
Well, aren't I nice to look at? Look
of course
at,
you're nice
I,
to look
I wink at you all the time and you look at me and say, what are you trying to do right now?
He's nice to look at. So it is enjoyable to
And his
go
name
down.
Is, it got a great name too. Hufflefinger.
Heffelfinger.
Hufflefinger.
No, it's Heff.
Huff. What's the difference?
Heffelfinger. Yes. But he does a wonderful job.
And his sidekick, Dr. Taub, who is also my oral surgeon, but Taub now basically set me and put me off now on Heffelfinger and doesn't want anything. When the two of them would do surgeries together, I mean,
Abbott and Costello.
Heffelfinger is like in a suit and tie, and Taub would come out in scrubs, and he'd have a donut on his shirt, and
Heffelfinger would be eating yogurt. He'd have a yogurt. He'd have a tea.
He's not like that. Like when he talks to me, he's very down to earth, and he talks to me.
Of course, he is.
I mean, for some reason, doctors get very comfortable with me. Little do they know that I have a track record of doctors dying.
Yeah, you're right.
I always tell our family doctor, be nice to me, because a lot of my doctors, lawyers, and pharmacists seem to die. The three most important people in my life, doctors, lawyers, and pharmacists. Always something has to happen. But
we struggle with them.
We had to go to Philly on, what was the day? Was it Monday?
Monday.
Monday we had to go to Philly. Well,
it was poured.
Pouring rain in Philly. It wasn't raining here in Northeast PA, but it was
the
pouring.
Remnants of Hurricane Ian.
Yeah. Well, they, you know what actually was, and I learned? It was the child of Ian, they said.
Oh.
Hurricane Ian actually, after the devastation down south, came up the coast. And yes, it impacted Washington and Philadelphia, but there was a low that developed because of Ian.
Gotcha.
On the coast.
And it rained
Ian,
for 3 days.
Well,
in Philadelphia.
Ian, actual Ian, Mama Ian or Daddy Ian went up left, but baby Ian then took over as the primary gotcha. Low. And that's what made it rain for like 4 days
I don't
in
really
Philadelphia.
Care. It just made it a nightmare trip driving to Philly in the rain.
You know, I have a very big problem sleeping at night. A lot of it's because of my jaw and being the pain and all that stuff. My dog likes to wake me up and go for a little jaunt in the yard in the middle of the night. She sleeps through everything.
Everything.
But then I had to get up at 6:30. I had to drive all the way to Philadelphia. I had to drive all the way home from Philadelphia while she sleeps in the passenger seat.
Okay.
Plus, when I'm down there, I have to get examined.
You can say that, but I do all the driving. You do
I
not
drove
do
home
the
from
driving.
Allentown.
You drove for a quarter of the trip.
Here's the thing. We can't drive to Philly usually without
a
switching. So when people say, oh, I drove to Nashville. We went right through. Did you start driving? No, I drove. We would be dead. We hardly could make it from here to Bloomsburg without
restroom.
Well, it's not even that. At one point, we start falling. See, I could drive at night. If we leave at midnight, I could drive till 8 in the morning without a problem. As soon as the sun comes up, I start falling asleep.
When we drove to Pittsburgh, when Sammy was out in the Pittsburgh area, we would do a 4-hour drive. I mean, we survived it.
I didn't do a 4-hour drive. I slept in the back seat.
Exactly. There, you just gave yourself away.
If I never had to drive again, I'm in fact thinking of going to my doctor and saying, take my license away.
Please don't.
I don't want to drive
anymore. I'm not driving your butt around everywhere
from
now on. I
hate driving, which is why I don't like...
Because you're an awful backseat driver on top of
yours. I'm a homebody. I like being at home. I like being around my house. I like working in my yard. I like going for walks around my place because when I'm in the city, how people live there, I have no idea. I mean, we got into Philly. First of all, the streets are so narrow. They're tearing stuff apart. My car is getting dirty. We pull into the parking lot. We finally find a spot on the 20th floor. We walk out in the pouring rain. We walk by a guy who's having a doobie sitting there trying to, I don't know what. He might have been homeless. He might not have been, but he's smoking up a doobie. This one gets halfway down, and because Philadelphia is such a lib town, they're still
wearing masks.
We kind of forgot your mask. People were wearing masks in the street.
Rain.
Not just one mask. They had a surgical mask and an N354 turbo on top of it. And I feel like saying to him, look, you're going to get COVID no matter what. So putting that mask on is not going to help.
I dropped my mask in the rain.
So then I'm stuck there in the parking garage.
I can get a new one.
The parking garage that is leaking on my head the whole time.
My feet were soaked by the time we got out of the parking garage.
Past the doobie man, back into the parking lot. And it just smelled like that. The parking lots in Philly just smelled like it's a urinal.
Yeah, they do.
All you could smell is urine the whole time you're in those parking lots.
You're
the
right.
Cities, New York, first of all, I will never go to New York City again. I don't want to be attacked by an axe. I don't want to be.
Goblin?
I don't want the Green Goblin stomping all over me. I don't want to be shot in the back. I don't want to be mugged.
Did you see in Poughkeepsie at Marist College? There was an incident.
They should find these people who do. No, I didn't see that.
Yeah, it was parents' weekend. And
oh, that I did. The father got shot or killed?
Yeah.
They should find these people.
That was in New York,
and
too.
An eye for an eye. That poor woman, the mother who got beat up in the subway by that man for no reason whatsoever, they should then get him, and they should punch him in the eyes so hard that he can't see. That would probably stop, but they don't care. They just walk in and do whatever they want to do, and we're just letting them do it. Because they still, this police bad, criminals good. Don't get me started.
Please don't come to our valley.
Because they're more concerned about wearing a mask than, and thank God, 99% of the world has finally
But if you have that
gone
attitude
past
of
COVID.
The city, don't come to our valley.
When I walk around the city and I see these people walking around with three masks on in the middle of the street outside, what in God's name do they think they're going to... I don't get it.
You need to get over it, though, because it doesn't affect you.
If they
want to wear a
mask,
let them wear a mask.
But if you see
somebody... The violence affects us. I don't care about a mask.
You know what? Those are the same people that if they see somebody smoking, they'll go over to and say, oh, you can't be smoking that cigarette. You know, it's not your business. So I won't bother you about your mask. You don't bother them about smoking.
They're wearing the mask. They can't smell
the smoke. I didn't go over to the guy with the doobie and say, you got to put that doobie out. It's bothering me. I care less.
I don't know if you would have made it out alive.
I'll smoke the doobie with you, dude. I don't care. Mm-hmm. The masks just drive me crazy because there's been such a narrative about them, and you don't know what was true and what wasn't true. It just drives me crazy. So,
get another message.
No, that's the Sam sending me nonstop Instagram messages.
I didn't get one.
Nonstop, she sends me.
I'm a little hurt. You got one and I didn't.
Anyway, what else do we got before we wrap things up? Oh, we got to talk about talking and I don't know.
Opportune times.
Opportune talking. This is something that's happened in our marriage, in our life since
the beginning.
The beginning. Where my lovely, wonderful, beautiful, sexy wife likes to tell me about her day during the most
It's the only time I have his full attention.
Inopportune time.
The only time I have your full attention.
I could remember.
If you'd sit down at the dinner table and eat dinner with me, I'd tell you that.
I highly doubt that. I could remember.
But you don't want to know
I could remember when the kids were little, or we might not even have kids yet. And I can remember the one night, candles lit, rose petals on the ground.
I think you're exaggerating.
Leading to the bed.
You're exaggerating now.
I'm telling her how much I love her. And she looks at me and said, do you know what Mrs. Casey said today? I got to tell you this right now.
I did. And I remember that. And I was good for a long time. I didn't say anything because that was like a pivotal.
What is that noise?
The chair.
Stop it.
It was like a pivotal
moment. Sounds like an alarm going off or something.
Did it stop?
Yes.
Then it was the chair.
So stop wiggling back and forth.
So that was like a pivotal moment because like at
pivotal
that point.
Moment.
Yes, because at that point, I didn't talk about anything else for a long time.
No, but you know what she did do? She fell asleep once.
Once.
Once. How about that, guys? There's a question for you.
I'm sure I'm not the only one.
All of a sudden. Jen, are you sleeping? No, no, I'm awake. You know how my manhood was hurt?
I probably said to you that night, Donnie, I'm really tired.
I know. It's always my fault. But don't go back and say that you still don't talk because I hear all about your school day.
I know. Again, maybe if you'd have dinner with me at the table.
So maybe the good doctor that you work with.
Okay. Dr. Pam.
Yeah, Dr. Pam wants to know that you're right in our bedroom, Dr. Pam. You are right there with us. Just remember that. At the most inopportune times, it's you, it's myself, Koffee, and Dr. Pam. Dr. Pam, you're right there in there with us. So it's kind of like a threesome or something because we got the three of you in here. We got Dr. Pam, Koffee, and Kramer.
Stop it.
All together.
That's not true.
Everybody joins us. It's amazing. So,
well, I was set off tonight. Usually it's because I'm set off about something. And then it just sticks with me. I have a hard time moving on.
I know. But I don't need all these people.
Once I get something in my head, it's hard to let it go.
I don't need all these people in our room with us.
I'm sorry.
It's kind of like, do you know what your mother said? No, Jen, I really do not want to know what my mother said right now, okay? Your mother called before. I forgot to tell you.
Make me laugh, which is going to make me cough.
Well, because these are the conversations. I mean, I'm sure this is probably normal for couples.
I'm sure other couples have the same issue.
Stop with the chair.
Sorry, you're making me nervous now.
I'm just saying, why? Because when Dr. Pam listens,
she's going to yell at me.
She's going to say, whoa, I'm right there with you, Dr. Pam.
She's not going to be happy with me.
Sometimes I got to watch. I don't say, instead of saying Jen, I say Dr. Pam. I never know.
Stop it.
And any person she's interacted with, that name could come up.
It happens. Aren't you glad it's like a female name, though, than not a male name?
Well, I'm just saying that
because
these things go through your mind there. Your mind should be clear. You should be thinking about sunflowers and sunshine and not about people at work.
It just happens. Again, have dinner with me and have a discussion.
Oh, and you're going to say that's going to cause it to...
And have a discussion with me, and then I won't have these conversations there. There. That's my say on this. It's your fault.
So next time we're in there, I'm going to say, hey, I was talking to Cooper today and Janet. I'll bring their names into it.
Okay.
You're just married because Dr. Pam is going to be mad at you. But yes, you are part of our bedroom conversation. Why? I don't know. But it's never bad. It's never anything bad. It's always something good. You know, but it's the name's always there.
Do you know what I heard today?
Do you know what Dr. Pam told me today?
You know what I heard?
First, I'm trying to think, okay, who are we talking about right now? I got to flip through everybody. Okay, and then if I don't listen to her, then it's just going to go on longer. So I've got to stop and I've got to listen. And then I say to her, anything else?
So he provokes more of a conversation.
Well, no, I ask her anything else so we don't have to
so
stop.
So we have more of a conversation.
But I want to make sure your mind is now
so
empty.
So then I do like a photo dump. I do a memory dump and everything just spills. I spill all the tea. It happens.
It's crazy.
You know, like there's some days I don't talk to another adult all day long.
Remember I used to tell you that when I was home with the kids? When you used to leave at 7:30 in the morning, I didn't talk to another adult until 3. And if you stayed later for some reason, by 5 o'clock. You wonder why I was on the phone with poison control, because I was trying to poison myself some days. I didn't talk to anybody.
Some days.
I just wanted to hear another. I call poison control. Nothing's wrong. I just want to hear an adult.
There's some days I walk into my room at 7:15, 7:30, and I don't walk out until 3, and I don't talk to another person.
Okay,
besides
but
a student.
You obviously talk to people.
11-year-old.
Since their names are being mentioned.
No, usually I get like texts after.
I think
school.
What happens is that she gets all the gossip at the end, so it's still fresh in her mind.
Or I get a text at night. That's what happens.
So from now on, what we're gonna do is we're gonna meet in the
Turn
studio.
My phone off at
no,
3
we're
o'clock?
Gonna we're gonna meet in the studio beforehand, and we're gonna talk, and then once it's all gone, we'll be fine, and then we can proceed to the next step.
Okay.
Nobody would want either of us because it would be a train wreck.
Train wreck.
That's all I'm going to say.
Yeah, well.
So, Dr. Pam, this one's for you, okay? Now that you know all the dirty secrets that go on.
Behind the scenes.
All right, don't forget, Decades is back on the air this coming Saturday. We have Top 9 at 9 Back in Time, and you're supposed to sing with me this week, too.
I have to sing with this
well,
voice?
Well, it'll sound sexy.
Okay. What so are we singing? Anything good?
I can't tell you. A duet. I told you what song we're singing.
Oh, I can't sing that song.
We'll be back again next week to another edition of Koffee and Kramer. Thanks for listening. Check us out on Facebook, the Koffee and Kramer Podcast. I'm Joey Kramer.
And I'm Jennifer Koffee.
And I'm Dr. Pam.
No, you're not.
And we are Koffee
and Kramer.